Good morning and welcome to Worksop. We're on the outskirts of Sheffield. It's Saturday morning. We travelled up yesterday. The journey up was horrible because of all sorts of diversions and all that stuff. But we got here to the Woodhouse Inn where they took care of us with some good food, good drinks, relatively good night's sleep as well. And now it's a half hour ride into Sheffield. And look, it's a glorious 10 degrees at the moment. Absolutely beautiful. I thought I was going to have to wear jumpers, lycras, vests, t-shirts. I've only got one layer on, plus this bad boy. But looking forward to the game. It's going to be a crunch match against the Blades today. We really need to put in a performance. I'm here with Steve, Tom, myself, Lucy, Ben and Adam. We've got six of us today. We'll be meeting up with more Cherries in the Sheaf Island, I'm absolutely certain. But for now, enjoy the match day vlog. If you haven't already, make sure you hit that subscribe button because there's going to be goals. I hope so anyway. Let's do this. Looks like Steve's finally woken up. Right, let's see if they've woken up. Morning!
Morning.
How are you, buddy? You
alright? Good, mate. I've got the Jeff on. I'm ready. I'm ready to go.
Alright. Should we tell something? What happened last night, mate? Something what? That kept you awake.
Oh, damn. You can...
Apparently I snore.
You can make a racket, mate. I hope you make as much noise in the away end today. Jesus, yeah. So I was up playing footy manager about 4 a.m. just to keep myself occupied. But,
I'm
you know,
sorry, mate.
I'll push through, mate. I'll push through.
Big game today, huge.
Massive, mate, yeah. I'm really sunk in how big it is, to be honest. Thinking about the other fixtures, I'm hoping we'll be looking after the game and going, it doesn't really matter whatever everyone else does now because we've done the job. But we could end up be thinking, oh, please do us a favour, Birmingham at Forest. But we'll see. It's going to be a tough game, but a game that suits us, I think. Yeah. I'm hoping they'll have a go. We'll catch them. Job done. Yeah, happy days, mate. Don't worry about it.
Let me give you a tour of the room.
Oh, go on.
There's the bathroom. Stylish square toilet. Not that comfortable to sit on, but all good. Lovely shade of towels. Look at that for a shower. Power shower as well. Beautiful. Want to heat your food up? No problem. There's a microwave. All sorts of settings. 800 watt as well. You'll get that food cooked in no time. And take a look at this for a double bed. Absolutely spacious. The thing of dreams, Tom.
It's lovely.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. A generous number of coat hangers. And also the piece de la resistance, a smart TV. Although the brand is Bush.
Oh, look at the lovely view we have here as well. Nice with the sun showing as well, mate. Oh, I do like that. That could be, I'll tell you what. Yes, lads. Yes, lads. Oh, little, did we, someone left their pint glass on.
Oh dear. So, our rating out of 10, we're going to come to Tom for this one. Tom, what are you going for?
Solid 8, mate. Solid 8.
We found parking and we're going to the Sheaf Island. Right then, 11:45. We don't often do this early. Tom, teams are out. Talk me through it. Is Cahill in the 11?
Mate, he's not even in the squad, mate.
He didn't travel.
No, he didn't travel. But I've got a respectable 10 out of 11 because Dembele has come in for Anthony. So that is the only change. Dembele for Anthony. Methan's on the subs bench instead of Cahill. Brady's on the bench instead of Stacey. No, Stacey. So, yeah. So they're the only changes. So, yeah, I expected changes, but only the one. I understand Dembele. I thought he made an impact and he scored in the last home game. So, yeah, interesting. I'm just going to try and, while you've got me on, mate, I'm going to try and look at the Sheffield one.
All right.
So it'll be interesting to see how they've gone.
Can
they've gone unchanged themselves. Yeah. So that's McBurney up front, Gibbs White just off him. So they've got no Billy Sharp. No, Billy Sharp's not in the squad.
Good.
But yeah, they've got Gibbs White, they've got McBurney, Fleck, Bird, so usual lot apart from that. So yeah, I'm relatively happy with that, mate. But
throwing caution to the wind by putting Dembele up there rather than Anthony, who made more track back, no interception,
yeah,
than anyone else.
I think it's more of a let Dembele go for it and then hopefully we get a lead, and then he's a good player to bring on for Dembele. I think we'll see that change whatever happens, but yeah, I understand that change. Interesting to see what's happened with Kale and Stacey, but whether Stacey's a tactical one to put Brady back in, not sure. But yeah, look forward to it, mate. Kind of what I expected, and it's in the bag.
In the bag.
Take a point.
Right, we've done the Wetherspoons, and lovely it was too. Nice little muffin brunch thing. A couple of drinks. Now, off to Bramall Lane, come on. Kelly's going for an own goal there. Cross came in and a bit of a miss kick. Uh-oh, that's it. Oh, my God. Lloyd Kelly off his own bar. Wow. We cleared it. It's fine. Oh, look at that. Look at that.
Sam, there's an opportunity to brush this side up today. 3 games in 8 days, filling for me should have started. Great return this season in stats. Todd Cantwell, why did we purchase him? He's sitting on the bench. There's a player in there, and maybe he should have thrown him in today. I think he needs to come on this pitch. Smith is getting overrun. He looks like he needs an oxygen tank in this half-time break. JC looks poor. It's just not quite clicking, really. We've had a few moments up top where we've tried to make something happen. Christie can't hit the target most of the time. It's not really happening, is it?
Hiya.
Hello.
I'll tell you what, mate, you missed the goal. You missed the save.
I missed nothing.
I
saw they were in and then I just heard it was a cracking save from Travers. So everyone's singing his name. That says it all about the half, really. We're probably hanging on a little bit. Chris had a few half chances that he doesn't know how to shoot. They're getting in a bit. There's been a lot of fouls. Seems to be a tactic of theirs. They've got to cut the bookings already. But I think they're on top, aren't they? I don't know.
They haven't done much. Okay, apart from the save, though, tested us.
It hasn't been a very good game. There's been a lot of fouls, a lot of stops in play. But I never know.
What do you think of this new chart, by the way?
Yeah, I like it.
I like it.
I didn't even mean that. fitting in well with Travers' man match at the moment. We're doing okay. I think there's a few players out there I think could have maybe been rotated. I think Binning looks pretty poor again. Dembele's doing alright. Doing alright when he gets the ball. But yeah, we never know, mate. A 0-0, like you say, apart from that one save, there are not causing too many problems. So could we nick something? We could be shouts away to a 1-0. Match that they feed you. We could, mate, we could. So keep the faith, but I won't even let you outside it, do you mind it? £4.80 for a can of lager. Disgrace.
We've got Neil Whedon here. Talk to me about that half, Neil. What do you think?
Yeah, I think we've done okay. We've done a lot of containing, haven't we, I think? And going forward, we've looked dangerous a couple of times. Do we get our shooting boots on? A little bit disappointed with JC, I think, on the left. He's not releasing Dembele quickly enough.
Not the first person to have said that.
Oh, really? Yeah. It's looked like that the last couple of games, to be honest. But I think we're doing okay. We're doing okay. They're a good team. They started off really bright and good, and then we came back into it. And, hopefully for the second half.
Fingers crossed. We're out early. Thankfully we're ready. Oh my God! What the fuck? That was the weirdest clearance I've ever seen in my life. Fire it across your own goal, lad. Wow! It's raining. Oh my God, Mark Travers yet again. Unbelievable save. Just missed it on camera, but long ball flicked over and there was a one-on-one and he was equal to it. Wow. Rightly getting the chance today. So close. I think it was Dom Solanke or Lloyd that just stabbed it. But then that Phillips knocked down. Better, but not exactly carving them open, are we? It's alright. Shit. There we go then. 0-0. Oh.
up to the fan cams.
It's just gone 7 o'clock and roads were really, really good actually. Got to say M1 was nice and clear, so certainly a lot quicker coming back than it was to get up to Sheffield, I'll say that. But just looked at the league table, worrying, there it is. Yeah, so Nottingham Forest won and have closed the gap to 6 points, and given we've got to play them at Dean Court and they're on such a good run of form, they are the team we need to look out for. I think in terms of our performance today, it was all right. It was better than Wednesday, but certainly didn't blow me away. But I think Sheffield United fans are going to feel very hard done by the fact that, I mean, that was a Stonewall penalty. Should have been a penalty. Wasn't. The referee sort of gave decisions that seemed to favour Bournemouth throughout, I've got to say. And they can probably look at that as being a couple of points dropped. But for Bournemouth, I think a lot of fans are fairly happy with getting that point and just trying to create some momentum ahead of two games now, which I've got to say probably must win. Middlesbrough at home and then Coventry away. If we get that, we are so tantalisingly close. But look, today was all about Mark Travers. What a boy. Super Mark Travers in goal. Wow. Pulled off an incredible save just before half time, and then another when it was a one-on-one in the second half. How many times are we going to need to thank him for keeping us in the game? We've done it all too often this season, and it's happened once again. But we go again. Hopefully we won't need to rely on him so much. And remember to subscribe, because we'll be seeing more of his heroics, plus the rest of the team, as we hopefully get a result against Middlesbrough on Good Friday. But up the Cherries. See you in the next video. And with Super Mark Travers in goal, anything's possible.